Okay, homeostasis, blood sugar control. First thing you need to really have an understanding of is the digestive system, because this will help place all the blood sugar control in context. One of the things you must be able to draw very quickly for yourself is a simplified diagram of the digestive system, and then be able to name all of the parts, foundation paper. So here we go. First thing you should be able to draw is a simple cavity, which will be the mouth. And a tube that takes food from the back of the mouth down to the J-shaped bag, which is the stomach. So, there's the stomach. The intestine comes out of the stomach. And then there are two tubes here that you've got to be able to draw. I'm sure you'll recognise them when you see them. This leaf-shaped structure is the pancreas, and this tube carries on down here to the large intestine, which we draw like this, that little structure there, the appendix, the exit, the anus, this structure here, which is called the rectum, and then the small intestine, which is much longer and more tightly coiled than this, because I'm keeping this diagram simple. I'll just give it a couple of coils like that. And this tube here, very important bit of knowledge for the higher paper, runs down the back of the stomach and fits. The gallbladder. Now, the liver is also drawn here, like this, on the top there, like that. Okay, I'll just shade the edge of the liver with these dots so you can see where it goes. This is a very stylized and simplified diagram. Takes a few minutes to draw. You can also add some salivary glands to your mouth. So there's the simple diagram. This is how you need to label it. I'll give you the initials and then I'll spell some of the more complex words. Okay, this is your mouth. This is where food is chewed to increase the surface area, so the enzymes can work on it. These are your salivary glands. They add saliva, which lubricates the food, so it can be moved down this tube here, which is called the esophagus. The esophagus is moved down the pipe. The food is moved down the esophagus by peristalsis. This is the stomach. This structure here is the liver. Structure here is the pancreas, this is the appendix, this is the anus, this is the rectum, this is the large intestine, sometimes called the colon, this is the small intestine, sometimes called the ileum. Now for the higher paper, you need to know that this structure here is called the gallbladder, and this tube that runs down there around the back of the stomach to there is called the bile duct. Those are all the structures that you need to be able to name and identify. Some of the spellings are a little bit complicated. Esophagus, ileum, which is the other name for the small intestine, colon, appendix, double P for appendix, pancreas, gallbladder, and bile you need to be able to draw and label that. Now, the pancreas is involved in the control of blood sugar, and so is the liver. The pancreas releases two hormones, insulin or glucagon, that tells the liver to do certain things. The pancreas is told what to do by the brain, which is up here somewhere. Okay, so if we now look at blood sugar control. Your blood sugar changes throughout the day because you use some of the sugar in respiration, but also when you eat a meal, your blood sugar levels increase and need to be brought back down. Your blood sugar levels are detected by the brain. And the brain tells the pancreas which hormone to release. The pancreas is a gland. That's anything that produces a hormone. Now, if your blood sugar levels are too high, the pancreas will release insulin, which will go to the liver. If your blood sugar levels are too low, your pancreas will release glucagon, which will go to the liver. And both of those hormones, as all hormones, are transported through the blood. Now, your liver can either store the glucose or release the glucose. And it will either store glucose as glycogen, or it will break down glycogen to release glucose. Now, people get confused by this because glycogen and glucagon have such similar names. So, if you think of it like this, it's a bit easier. Glycogen in the liver. That's your glucose store. And then if you think of glucose in the blood, because that's where you're going to use it from. Now, if your blood sugar level is too low, the pancreas releases glucagon. If your blood sugar levels are too high, the pancreas releases insulin, the brain tells it to do this. So, blood sugar levels too high, glucose is taken out of the blood and stored in the liver as glycogen. If the blood sugar levels are too low, glycogen is broken down and glucose is put back into the blood. Glucagon tells the liver to do that. Insulin tells the liver to do that. Now, hormones are made by glands. And they are transported in the blood. And eventually, the blood takes them to the organ that they're meant to affect, which is called the target organ. In the case of blood sugar control, the gland is the pancreas. The target organ is the liver, and the two hormones are insulin and glucagon. Now, The reason this topic's so hard is because the language is so complicated.